Hello, Internet. Duke of the Bump here. And this is the Binding of Isaac, Wrath of the Lamb, version 1.15. There's actually been two updates since the last time I streamed this, and a lot of the bugs were fixed, which is good. I am back from vacation. Oh, welcome to the chat room, Scared Helmet. Let me type something into the chat room. Oh, and welcome to the chat room, Kibbis 2000. Let's see. Typing into the chat room. There we go. Welcome to the chat room, Kostya. Twitch is acting kind of weird today because they did the big layout update and the chat room is being kind of wonky. So if I don't say hello, I apologize because I can't see everybody. Like right now, Scared Helmet is the only one showing up in the chat room. Well, as you can see, I have done a few things. Well, you can see one thing I've done since the last time I streamed. I have the puzzle piece here instead of the normal title screen, which for me would be It Lives. And this puzzle piece indicates that I have completed the game with one character. And by complete the game, it means I beat the new area. You know how there's an alternate area that the Wrath of the Lamb expansion added for every area in the game? Like, the alternate version of the basement is the cellar, the alternate version of the caves is the catacombs. Well, the alternate version of Sheol is the cathedral. And I have completed that part of the game with Isaac. There are six puzzle pieces here, meaning you have to complete the cathedral with all six characters. Well, all six real characters, not killing the blue baby, to get the real ending to the game. Welcome to the chat room, CPC Gamer. So yeah, to completely beat the game, we'd have to beat it with Isaac, Maggie, Cain, Judas, Eve, and Samson. And as you can see, I did unlock Samson, and he is yet another shitty character that I am probably never going to use. The Bloodlust is really awesome. It makes you do a little bit more damage for each enemy you kill in the room, and it stacks pretty high. But his starting stats are just so miserable that there's no point in actually playing with him. The Bloodlust doesn't make up for his horrible stats. And since I did beat the game with the blue baby, also known as ... Isaac now has the D6, which is a pretty awesome item. It lets you reroll for any item in an item room, or basically any item in the game that's not a card, pill, bomb, key, heart, or trinket. Any item, if the D6 is fully charged, you can hit space, and it'll give you another random item instead. Welcome to the chat room, Anime Flame 12 and Chaotic Harmony. Who is ... That is the blue baby. You unlock him for beating the game 10 times. And then, if you beat the game with him, then you unlock the D6 for Isaac. And the blue baby is a joke character. He starts with no actual hearts, he just starts with 3 soul hearts, and he starts with the poop, and all that does is it spawns a piece of poop, just like any other piece of poop in the game. Samson is considered a berserker, yet he has a slow fire rate. Also, the new audio sounds good. Thank you. I appreciate it. I spent a bit of money on the equipment setup, and I hope it makes a difference. So, now that we've beaten the game 10 times, really there are 3 main objectives. There's beating the game with beating Sheol with every character, which is a huge pain in the ass. Sheol is extremely difficult, and I've only managed to beat it twice, once with Cain and once with Eve. And to actually complete the game, of course, you want to beat the cathedral with every character. And that's what I'm going to be working on in the streams to come. There's also the challenges, which was added in the expansion, and I totally forgot to show it in my first video. Each of these, you just play a game with another condition. The first one is Dark Was the Night, and what that does is the Curse of Darkness that makes it so you can't see the map is in effect for the entire game. And I haven't really tried out the other ones, but I do plan on doing these on stream once I beat the cathedral once I complete the game normally. But I can only assume that the challenges just get harder and harder. I was watching a stream, and I know that Isaac Was Good Today is kind of a reverse challenge. You start with, like, the Holy Grail and some other awesome items, and it's, basically a reprieve from the difficult challenges. But then the Purist, I think, you have to play through the entire game with no item rooms, just whatever you get from boss drops, which sounds hellish, but, I'll try it one of these days. Do you unlock anything from challenges? I'm not sure. I mean, there's an achievement for each challenge, obviously. Actually, I don't think there's an achievement for number 10, but there is an achievement for 1 through 9, but I'm not sure if anything actually unlocks in the game. Chaotic Harmony says, I know at least challenge 6 gives you something. The Epic Fetus. Oh, yeah. There's a better version of the fetus that, where you fire, well, you drop bombs on people, like the remote control, the doctor's remote, the one that drops bombs on people. The Epic Fetus gives you the ability to do that for every shot. So anyway, enough screwing around. Let's start. I will be playing, let's see, I already completed the game with Isaac. So as much as I'd like to show off the D6, I want to try to do a cathedral run with Cain. And we have the Curse of the Labyrinth, which is the extra large version of the cellar. I'm playing on a new keyboard. The keyboard I usually play on, the spacebar broke, and my replacement keyboard that I was using, the shift key sticks, which is really annoying. So I just bought another cheap keyboard. Nothing special, but it works well enough. Might take a little getting used to, though. There's a chest here, but I'm going to save both of my keys. Because when you have the Curse of the Labyrinth on level 1, unlike normally, normally the first item room in the game doesn't require a key to unlock, but when you have the Curse of the Labyrinth, both item rooms on this level require a key. So I will hold on to my keys for now. It turns out Cain is nerfed when he gets technology 2. Yeah, that's an interesting point. Normally when you get technology 2, You're still firing tears out of your other eye, because only one of your eyes is replaced by the laser eye. But when you're Cain, you don't have that eye, so you just get the laser, not the tears, which kind of sucks. But I mean, I would still say, yeah, even when it's nerfed, Technology 2 is still better than just normal, you know, vanilla tears. Obviously, if you have some damage upgrades, then you might want to think twice before you get Technology 2. I thought that Technology 2 actually replaced Technology 1, but it turns out you can still get Technology 1. Like, they're actually not sure which one this is. Okay, yeah, that's Technology 2. Similar to Technology 1, except that instead of firing a laser at intervals, you fire it constantly. And normal damage upgrades and stuff that would stack with Technology 1 don't stack with Technology 2. So it has its pluses and its minuses. If you manage to get the mulligan, it spawns flies every time you hit something, and that stacks supremely well with Technology 2. Because, you know, every pulse of the laser is technically a hit. So if you get the mulligan, you're just spawning just dozens and dozens of flies. It's amazing. Vanilla tears taste like sorrow. Well, I know Vanilla Co. tastes like sorrow, so if Vanilla Tears is anything like that, then yeah, I would say that's accurate. It would be nice if I got the mulligan in this playthrough, but I won't get my hopes up. Halo, or no, not the Halo, the Crown of Thorns. This is just a damage boost, but I'm not sure if this one will actually stack with Technology 2. As you can see, my damage is nerfed down to 1. And it's still 1, so I would say that probably doesn't give me any benefit. Usually when it's a bloody effect on the tears, that's an effect that won't stack with technology. But I think I'm pretty sure there are still some damage boosts that will stack with technology too. I'm just not sure which ones. I hear it works well with brimstone as well. Still have not actually gotten brimstone. Sure, I'll sacrifice one bomb to get two. So I got an interesting bug when I was playing this game the other day. And this was even with the 1.5 patch, or 1.15, or whatever it is. When the first level of the game is an XL level, a Curse of the Labyrinth, this has happened to me twice now. It's possible to get a bug where you bomb your way into a secret room, and then the secret room has two offshoots off of it that don't go anywhere. They don't connect with any other part of the level. And I was just experimenting with that. I was playing around and I got stuck in a room because I was off in one of the little branches and I ran out of bombs. I didn't have any way to get back out. And I tried to record a video of it just for posterity, but then Steam started freaking out and... Damn, I was hoping to get this block with that bomb. Steam started freaking out and like a million copies of Binding of Isaac opened for some reason, and I had to shut down everything. It was causing me to crash. Hey, what's up, Morse? Does the laser ever run out? Nope, this is a permanent upgrade. But yeah, that was kind of a weird bug. And I got it again when I was playing the other day, but I knew by that point... Actually, I had the Ipecac, so getting out wasn't an issue at that point. But, yeah, I mean, there's nothing special when the little off... I mean, I assume it's a bug. I assume... It's not supposed to be like that, because there was nothing special in the little offshoots. Chat room is being weird with the new layout update from Twitch. Yeah, the chat room is being kind of lame. So anyone in the chat room who wants to shout out, introduce yourself, because I can't see it when you join. Is there a new different plot to this one, or is it the Binding of Isaac but more of it? Yeah, pretty much that. New items, or more items, more bosses, more levels. I mean, really, the story in Binding of Isaac was pretty thin to begin with, but the Wrath of the Lamb doesn't really add anything to it. And I bombed for secret rooms, just checking, but I also got a couple coins there. There is another ending. Yeah, that's true. I got the ending for Sheol and the ending for the Cathedral, and neither one really... Nothing really happens in either of them. I mean, it's a little cutscene, but you know, there's no dialogue or actual story or anything. But you know, it's a neat little bonus. Welcome to the chat room, Darian Mask. Thank you for coming to my stream. So yeah, back from vacation. I had a glorious 9 days off. Hopefully, it looks like that one actually stacks with the laser. I had a glorious 9 days, and I played a ton of video games. Oh, wow. Suddenly, I can see a lot of people who just joined. Welcome, Paradox Zero, Duncan CMT, Odin337, Cody Farf, Grey Words, and For the Love of NES. Welcome to all of you. So yeah, hopefully I can resume my regular bi-weekly stream, sometimes tri-weekly, when I can play on Sundays. Out of bombs. Oh well. And I could use this key to go to the item shop, but I only have 5 pennies, so that would be kind of a waste. Are all of these coins on the map trapped behind blocks? Yeah, I guess so. Can't pick up any of those. Okay. Well, I guess that's good enough. Let me pick up one of these hearts. Any plans of picking up Terraria with Mors again? Yeah. I mean, if he wants to, and Namajim wants to, then I'd definitely be up for some more of that. Crazy combo I had with technology and brimstone. Yeah, someone was just saying that they're stacked really well. Excellent. That is a good trade. Now that I have 7 coins, I'll go ahead and open the item shop, just in case there's anything on sale. I could buy a card, but I think I'll hold on to what I have. Speaking of Terraria, you guys heard of Starbound. Do you mean Starforge? There's this indie Minecraft-esque game called Starforge that's built with Crysis engine, I think it is. That looks pretty interesting. There's a cool video of it floating around on YouTube. I'm not sure if that's what he's talking about. Welcome, Serious Coffee Demon. Oh shit. That's what I get when I click out of the window. Click back in, or else I die. Ken's a new boss. I had him last time. He's pretty easy. I say as I get blasted by a puke. I think all this does is spawn a tarot card and maybe a soul heart. No, just a tarot card. Oh, tears up. So there's also a damage effect. Okay, good. Strength or the Hanged Man? Well, I'll take strength, use it in the next boss room, and I'll come back for the Hanged Man. Definitely want to continue Terraria, Moore says. Hopefully sometime this week. Yeah, that'd be cool on Sunday. I just played Minecraft recently, CPC Gamer says, and honestly, it didn't hook me. Nothing happened, and then I died. Yeah, that was pretty much my experience with Minecraft. Try Terraria. It's like Minecraft, but better, in my experience. Starbound is basically Terraria in space, with races and a lot of procedurally generated stuff. Oh, cool. Is it free? Whenever you have the cellar on the first level, you're really likely to run into Widow. And Widow's kind of a pain in the ass to deal with. Luckily, my technology is doing a pretty good job on her there. If you just had normal blot tears and you run into Widow on the first level, you have a pretty good chance to die. She's not easy. And meat gives us tears plus hit points up. No stat bonus. It's probably just a fire rate bonus, which doesn't apply since we have technology. Alright, well, that went pretty well. Oh, I forgot to use strength. Didn't even have to. Well, I'll hold on to this, because the hangman is kind of useful, but hopefully I'll find an item that lets me fly anyway. Is it deleting links? That sucks. Oh, welcome to the chat room, Ninfreaklin and V-Caliber. How are you not shooting your tears while shooting your laser, V-Caliber says. It's because I'm Cain. I don't have the extra eye, so I don't get the tears. But it's still a pretty nice upgrade. Oh, apparently the meat is a reference to, I think it was Bonk's Adventure. It has the little vein on his forehead is a reference to the meat power-up in that game. I think it was Bonk's Adventure. Oh, welcome, Jace-Z. Jace-Z. If I mispronounce any of your guys' names, feel free to correct me. I am not too proud to admit when I'm wrong at the pronunciation. I did look at the pronunciation of Sheol, though, and apparently that's how it's supposed to be pronounced, Sheol. I thought it might be Shoal, but the E is pronounced. So I played quite a few games on my vacation. I talked about them a little bit in the last video. I played through all of VVVVVV, which is a great game. Oh, speaking of which, Humble Indie Bundle 5 is up, and VVVVVV isn't one of the games, but it has Limbo, Psychonauts, Amnesia, The Dark Descent, and if you pay the minimum amount, it also comes with Bastion, which was like $7 the last time I checked. definitely worth it. Oh, and Super Brothers Swords and Sorcery. Halo Flies, not bad. Pretty bog standard. Is this for PC? Yes. This is available on Steam. $5, $3 for the expansion. Yeah, I always try to support the Humble Bundle whenever I can. In this instance, I already had all of the games, except for Super Brothers. But I made a small donation, so I could get that one as well. No way to get these bombs, unfortunately. If I get another bomb, then I can blow this one up and then blow up one of the inside bombs, but nothing I can do right now. Yeah, the Humble Bundle 5 has made like $3 million so far. It's pretty crazy. I'll go ahead and use this key. Why not? Yeah. That wasn't really worth it. Okay. I'll get a soul heart and replace my key. That's good enough. You can jump over pits. Nope. It's like the original Legend of Zelda. You can get a ladder that can help you cross the pits. Or there are items you can get that let you fly over the pit, but no jumping. Yeah, if you don't want Bastion, you only have to pay a minimum of $1. Well, actually, there's no minimum, but it's a minimum of $1 if you want the Steam codes for the game. But if you don't have the, if you don't care about Steam, you can get it. Get them for pretty much nothing. Wow, another fly. Sweet. Welcome to the chat room, Enhanced Wizard. Thank you for coming. I hope you enjoy my stream today. Welcome, Sore Thumb. Oh, Sore Thumb, I saw you got the D20 achievement. Did you have to do everything again, or did the achievement unlock eventually? I got the D20 for completing the game with Isaac, but I did that before the Steam achievements actually were pushed out, but I ended up getting the achievement automatically, but Sore Thumb was having some issues with it. It wasn't the D20 that had the issue, it was the Celtic Cross. I see. Yeah, most of the issues have been worked out in the two updates so far. There's just the one that I mentioned earlier. And I haven't seen any other bugs other than that since the second update. Welcome to the chat room, Lelouch Hero. Thank you for coming. Okay, I guess I'm pretty much done here. Good old Chub. I breathe a sigh of relief whenever I get a boss that's not the Blighted Ovum. If you haven't gotten the Blighted Ovum yet, it's pretty much the most bullshit boss in the game. Unless you can fly. If you can fly, it's no problem. But if you can't fly, then you're going to have a bad time. Welcome, Benji Orangey. Chaotic Harmony says, Blighted isn't that bad, it's the Bloated that's bad. Well, I haven't gotten the Bloated Ovum yet. Let's hope I don't. Let's see. Unfortunately, the Ouija board doesn't stack with Technology 2. Which sucks, because I'm pretty sure it stacks with Technology 1. That's quite the weapon stat combo I've got there. Oh, welcome, Pariah with a 4. Yeah, I'm not doing too bad for myself. I like the laser a lot. Whether it's 1 or 2. How can you fly? Originally, you could fly by getting Transcendence, or the Pony, or the Lord of the Pit items, but the expansion added like 3 other items that let you fly, at least. There's the Holy Grail, the Dead Dove, and something else that's not coming to me right now. Oh, Rain of Sodden, welcome. How much of Wrath of the Lamb have I done? Not much. I beat the Cathedral with Isaac, and that's pretty much it. Off stream, I've been focusing on trying to get the Sheol achievements, Oh, I actually got the Basement Boy achievement to beat the basement without taking any damage, which I didn't think I was even going to get that one. And I'm pretty confident I'm not going to get any of the other no damage achievements. Let's see, the Ace of Spades. I used to know what these did. The Matchstick occasionally gives you, it occasionally drops a heart when you clear a room, I think. So I think that's what I'm going to take. Or maybe I'm thinking of the Ace of Spades. I don't know. I'm still not 100% clear on most of the trinkets, unfortunately. No damage achievements will come. Yeah, I hope so. I mean, I had to actively try to get the Basement Boy achievement. It was not fun. It is a lot easier with Isaac, though, once you get the D6, because you can reroll. I'm going to hold on to my key. You can reroll for items, and basically, if you don't get an item that lets you fly, and you're going for the cave boy, the Splunker boy, or whatever, or Mama's boy, or any of those, it's not going to work out. Because you end up getting into situations where you're just completely screwed. There's no way to get out of. You enter a room and you're just surrounded by enemies, and there's no way to dodge them unless you can fly. But when you have the D6, those items are easier to come across. Awesome, got some bombs. Can actually start looking for secret rooms now. Back during the times of Sheol, I had a complete no damage run all 9 floors. Wow. I will never, ever be able to do that. Of course, Reign of Sodden is a much more skillful gamer than I am. He's one of those speedrunner guys on SDA, and he does all these crazy Symphony of the Night speedruns and stuff. That stuff just blows my mind. Damn, I should have gone back for the heart. Oh well. This looks like it might be a secret. Excellent. Oh, by the way, there are 2 secret rooms on every floor now. I'm pretty sure it's every floor has 2 secret rooms. There's a standard one, and then there's either a cathedral room or a womb room. And a womb room typically has a bunch of hearts. I think it's 8 every time. I'm not sure if both show up on every floor or not, but I got the x-ray glasses at one point, and I was getting both rooms on every single floor. Yeah, the x-ray glasses are way better now that there are 2 secret rooms instead of just 1. The secret room has varying loot. Yes, there's a normal secret room and then the secret room. Oh, welcome, Ventus Knight. Glad you can make it. Matchstick increases the chance of receiving bonds from drops. Ace of Spades improves chance of tarot cards being dropped. So I was wrong on both counts. I was thinking of something else for the matchstick. Oh, I was thinking of the fork, I think. Isaac's fork. Is there anything to indicate where secret rooms are? Well, sort of. There used to be kind of a pattern for the secret rooms. Like, they would always appear adjacent to at least 2 other rooms. But I think now that the update's out, that might have changed, because I've definitely found secret rooms that don't follow that pattern. Oh, welcome, Lusoka. Thank you for coming to the stream. Hello, baby fistula. Oh, there's a mini version of of Gertie now, my least favorite boss. And the mini version sucks. You don't usually see him until much later in the game. But it is not a pleasant mini boss at all. Aw, man. I wish I had my D6, because I would re-roll for this piece of shit. All the black bean does is makes you fart whenever you get hit. Which is okay, I guess, but I don't like any items that require you to be hit for them to activate. Because I spend as much time as possible trying not to be hit. Yeah, the black bean makes your character look fatter, but it doesn't actually affect your speed. Unlike the lard, which makes you fat and affects your speed. Aw, man. Stupid greed. There are super versions of all of the sin mini-bosses now. Sin, greed, lust, wrath, etc. They're not too much worse than the normal versions, but they are still formidable. As a seasoned Judas player, I'm used to dodging that and mauling enemies with high damage. But God bless you, sir. I mean, Cain's hard enough to play starting with two hearts. I would never regularly use a character where you only start with one. Either Judas or Samson. Sure, I'll go ahead and use my card. Why not? So, Edmund McMillan, the creative mind behind Binding of Isaac, has a blog, which you can find at edmundm.com. And he also has a forum string where people ask him questions, and it can be kind of amusing. Someone asked him what fistula was supposed to be. They're like, what's fistula supposed to be? It just looks like a big ball of skin and hair and stuff. And his response, well, it's supposed to be a fistula. Apparently somebody should have Googled before asking. Aw, man. Oh, that's not too far out of my way. Wow, I have a lot of money. Oh yeah, that's the blood machine one. I don't think I want to use that. The flat penny's pretty good. If I remember correctly, and it's quite possible I don't remember correctly, it gives you a chance of getting a golden key every time you pick up a coin. And what the golden key does is it lets you open any lock on that floor. So any chest, any item room, any shop, you can unlock them all on that floor if you have the golden key. But that might be one of the other items I'm thinking of. Because there are like three new... Oh, yep, that's the right one. I also love the sound effect when you pick up the golden key. It's a nice little tone and then a click. Gold keys every time you pick up money. Nice. Does the fart hurt enemies? No, well, it poisons them, which does damage over time. But the radius on the fart is so small that it's really not worth, you know, it's not worth taking a hit, that's for sure. And poison damage, it can be good, but only if you can repeatedly poison enemies. Welcome, Fragrant Parrot. Announce his presence in the chat room by saying the word penis. Always nice to see an eloquent member of the Twitch community come into the chat room. The fart doesn't go away until used. The black bean, it's a permanent power-up. CPC Gamer says, thank you for that contribution, my good sir. Damn. Yeah, that's the black bean in action. Now, if you can get an item that makes your tears do poison damage, that's actually pretty good, because you can do steady poison damage. You can steadily poison enemies, and it increases your total DPS by a pretty good amount. It looks like this keyboard might be an issue, because it's occasionally acting weird when I try to press three keys at once. Like if I'm strafing and I try to fire, like it's, see, I'm strafing down and to the right, and then when I try to fire, nothing happens. When I try to fire right, nothing happens, but when I try to fire left, it works. There's really no reason to keep picking up golden keys. I just like the little sound effect. The little jingle. Yeah, the golden key isn't every time you pick up a coin, just most times. It might be your keyboard. Yeah, this is a new keyboard, so that's some kind of drawback, I assume. Greatest entrance available to all high-classing gentlemen, Chaotic Harmony says. Indeed. The sound effect creeps sore thumb out. Why does it creep you out? It's cool. Well, I have 8 bombs, so I guess I should start bombing some walls. Oh, sorry, sore thumb. I probably shouldn't pick all of those up since it creeps you out. There's a new power-up with the expansion that gives you 99 bombs. Kind of like the skeleton key that gives you 99 keys. And having 99 bombs is awesome, because you can just go around bombing every single wall. So you're guaranteed to get every secret room on a level. A joystick may be a good option as well. I've always liked using the keyboard. There's some games that I like using a controller with, like 2D platformers like Limbo and VVVVVV. But for this game, I don't know, I think a keyboard just works. Now granted, I haven't tried a controller with this game, but I think it would be hard for me to get used to using a controller at this point. I love that setup, when there's just a bunch of boils clustered around an explosive barrel like that. Damn it. I was afraid it would be these guys. Ah, damn it. My little halo's been pretty good about protecting me from projectiles. Aw. Oh yeah, I have the laser. You guys are useless. That's the best reason to have the laser right there. Duke is Wrath of the Lamb harder than the original? That's kind of debatable. I mean, a lot of the bosses are harder, and the alternate version of the levels are harder, but there are also a lot of really great items, and you seem to get them a lot more frequently in Wrath of the Lamb. Although, that might no longer be the case, since apparently Edmund nerfed some of the item distribution in the most recent update. Ah, Loki. Loki's not really that hard to deal with. Okay, yeah, this keyboard is definitely gonna be an issue. I'm gonna have to get my old crappy keyboard back out. The reason I replaced my crappy keyboard is because the shift key, the right shift key, stuck, which made typing a chore. But this is gonna, yeah, it's worth mentioning that it's something that a lot of keyboards have. You want to look for an anti-ghosting keyboard, which I forgot to check for when I bought this crappy keyboard. Alright, devil or angel? Devil. Man, I haven't gotten an activated item yet. It's kind of a bummer. If I had more hearts, I'd get the nail. Since the nail's pretty sweet. But I do not. Oh wait, I haven't even gotten the item room on this level. The hell am I thinking fighting the boss? For some reason, I thought I was in the womb already. Oh, there's a new item, the mitre, which is like a pope hat, and it gives you a chance of spawning an item room in the womb, which is pretty cool. I've gotten it a couple times, but I haven't made it to the womb on any of those playthroughs, so I haven't had a chance to test it out. The downside is that when people say anti-ghosting, usually they're overdoing it, making it so no keys can conflict, when really the WASD area and direction pad space are very useful. Well, I mean, that's how my last keyboards were. There were no, you press all the buttons you want all day, and it didn't give you any problems. Shit. Yeah, if I die, I'm going to break out my old keyboard. Hate to have to do that, but this is definitely giving me issues. Alright, death. Sweet. Wow, look at all this money I have. Wow, another fly. Aw, but 3 is the maximum. Oh well. The habit recharges your item a little bit every time you get hit. And obviously I don't have an item, but I have 51 coins, so why the hell not? Can't hit 3 keys at once. Whoa, why is it? Oh, never mind. I was stuck looking the other direction. Yeah, I mean, some 3-key combinations I can do, and some I can't. You also have 7 deadly sins right from the start. Wait, what's Rain of Sodden talking about? The game is currently not properly splitting hard mode enemies out of the normal low clear modes. I didn't know it was supposed to. Although, I guess that wouldn't make sense. The habit makes for some odd-looking characters. If you're talking about odd characters, the habit's the least of your problems. I've gotten so many crazy power-ups that Cain or Isaac or whoever was no longer even recognizable as human. He just becomes a monster. Oh, when you get Isaac and Wrath of the Lamb at the same time, there's that difficulty spike at the beginning. Yeah, that's kind of a bummer. So even if you haven't cleared the game at all, you can still get Super Envy or Super Insert Sin here. Yeah, that sucks. I'm glad I was pretty much through with the game by the time the expansion came out. Alright, see you later, Sortha. Oh boy. Normally I would pick this up, but honestly I'm kind of digging the laser. I mean, Epic Hack is great if you don't have a good weapon, but it can also be difficult to use. It's kind of like Dr. Fetus in that it's very easy to hit yourself. How much does Isaac plus the expansion cost? Binding of Isaac is $5 and Wrath of the Lamb is $3. which is really a tremendous value. Fuck Epic Hack. I mean, I like it if I get it right at the beginning of the game. And I've beaten the game with Epic Hack before. But, yeah, in this situation, no. Oh, I forgot to get the heart. Oh well. I got Epic Hack with the Sacred Heart, slow homing shots, and it was amazing. Yeah, I heard that's a really great combination. Man, I hope there's something good in the item shop on this level. I wish I had money as power. Oh shit. Oh, thanks guys. Totally saved me a bomb. Yeah, that's another nice thing about Epic Hack. It's like having 99 bombs. You can just go around bombing every single wall. Oh, speak of the devil. Speaking of the devil, I hate fighting the devil. I would say that the Cathedral is actually easier than Sheol. For the people who were asking if Wrath of the Lamb is harder than base Binding of Isaac. Because the boss of the Cathedral, you have to fight. Well, I won't spoil it. I won't spoil it. Hopefully I'll get to the Cathedral tonight. Which mushroom is that? Is that the good mushroom or the bad mushroom? That's pretty good. Speed plus range. Really, there's only one bad mushroom, and it's only bad some of the time. Oh, I hate these things. Easy to deal with if you're flying, but they can be a huge pain in the ass. Especially in a room that's cluttered like this. You know what? I think I'm going to use my death card on this one. I'm going to use a lifeline. I never encountered Daddy Longlegs yet. Yeah, me either. Oh, welcome to the chat room, Chibi Soma. Thank you for coming to the stream. I still have no idea which alternate cathedral boss is. Well, hopefully you will see tonight. Oh, there are three cathedral bosses? Oh, I didn't know that. I've only fought the one. Man, I'm fast. God damn it. I hate it when you get exactly the same enemies in two rooms in a row. Shit. Oh well, at least I'm at the boss. Shit! Why did that thing blow up so quick? I should probably go looking for the item room, since I have all this money. My luck, it'll spawn a super greed and I'll die. But I have to at least try. See you later, Kibitz. Oh, arcade. That's another thing I can blow some of this cash on. I have some pennies burning a major hole in my pocket. Oops. Oh well. Alright, let's get some stuff. Oh, the pinky eye. That's actually really good. I don't know if it stacks with the laser, though. Normally, the pinky eye gives all of your shots a chance of doing poison damage. But I'll have to test it to see if it works with the laser or not. Mars Dracoon said kind of a waste. I assume he meant using a bomb to get a penny, but, you know, I have 97 bombs, so I'm not that worried about wasting bombs. Aww. Hoping to get a poop hat. Oh, another chance at a poop hat. Excellent. Flies are no longer an issue. I love fighting the Duke of Flies when I have the poop hat too. Stacks with Dr. Fetus, so I would assume it stacks with technology as well. Hopefully. Man, I need some hearts. This thing probably isn't going to give them to me. Two of Spades doubles your key count, I believe. Yes. And then the Two of Clubs doubles your bomb count. And if you get the Two of Hearts, it doubles your hearts. And if you have zero keys or zero bombs, then the Two of Spades or the Two of Clubs, respectively, will give you two of that item. The pin occasionally lets your make your tiers go through obstacles like you have via the Ouija board, but it doesn't stack with technology, so I won't. I won't pick it up. I think I want to bomb this thing. Mom's Pearl, still haven't figured out what that one does. When there's a bunch of trinkets scattered around like this. Oh, I discovered that there's an item called, I forget what it's called. It's a bag of something, like a bag of tricks. But whatever it is, it lets you hold two trinkets instead of one, which is pretty cool. This makes hearts drop more often when you fight enemies in clear rooms. The tick, it makes bosses spawn with less health, but once you get the tick, you can't pick up any other trinkets. You're stuck with the tick forever. And it sucks that it dropped on top of the pinky eye because I was going to pick that up again. Mom's Purse, that's an item that spawns a bunch of pills around you, I think. Mom's Pearl, greater chance of finding mom's items from golden chests. Oh, interesting. Oh yeah, Mom's Coin Purse is the one that drops pills everywhere. Mom's Purse is the one that lets you hold an extra trinket. Well, should I try picking up the pinky eye, or should I stick with the heart? I think I'm going to stick with the heart. Oh, that's pretty good. Let's see if the trinket spawned any differently when I enter the room again. Nope. Oh well. I will just stick with the heart for now. Yeah, if you get the trinket room upgrade, you can get the tick as well. But you can't swap the tick out for anything. Put a bomb down and maybe it will blow them apart. Yeah, that's not a bad idea. Oh, shit. I got a little bit too close. Oh well, looks like I'm stuck with the tick. Mea culpa. Oh yeah, these flies can't do anything to me. Friends till the end. That spawns three blue flies around you. The blue flies are different from the normal flies because they launch themselves at your enemies, and you can have more than three of them at a time. Sure. Well, actually I should probably see what's in this item shop before I give you any- Damn it! Another greed. Called it. Of course, I said it was going to be super greed, not greed, but still, close enough. Alright, it's your lucky day, guy. Ooh, well, doesn't do anything with my laser. But, oh well. Probably should have killed that guy when I had the chance. Alright, screw those other rooms. I'm just going straight to the boss. I could start bombing all these walls to see if I can find the other secret room. Nah, that's too time consuming. I don't want to do that on the stream. With old technology, that was the Uber combo. Yeah, that's true. All right, Mom. Mom is a lot more difficult with the expansion because the foot is a lot harder to avoid. It does a lot more splash damage than the foot did before. So you have to get pretty far away from it to avoid being hit. Alright, well that wasn't bad. This is Guppy's furball. Or hairball. It's like a little thing that like you can swing around you and it does damage to enemies. But it's difficult to use. Supposedly it gets bigger the more enemies you kill with it, but I haven't seen it yet. I don't get why people like Ouija boards so much. There aren't a lot of situations where it really comes in handy. Oh, I beg to differ, Kostya. If you're fighting any enemies that shoot projectiles, then it's very useful to be able to take cover behind rocks. And you can return fire. Especially stationary enemies. Since I have so many bombs, I'm just going to go around blowing up rocks just to see if any of them hold any secrets. Although, it will be a good idea for me to save some of these bombs. Well, if I was fighting Satan, it'd be a good idea to hold on to some bombs, but I don't know what kind of boss I'll be fighting in the cathedral. I've only fought one boss in the cathedral so far, but apparently there are multiple bosses you can potentially encounter. According to what Rain of Sotin said. Nice. Yeah, Ouija board plus technology. Technology 1 is amazing. Because the laser goes through both enemies and blocks. So you can pretty much shoot anything from anywhere. Games being kind of mean, giving me two of these guys in room one. It's not very fair. Alright, do I do the challenge room? Compass. Well, that actually is pretty useful for the womb, since I can just go straight to the boss. How many different bosses are there? Yeah, there's a ton. There's like 30 something. Oh yeah, I'm in utero, not the womb. Never mind. I wonder if, just out of curiosity. Nope, I was hoping there would be a secret room on one side of this so I can just bomb my way out. Oh well. Larry Larry, by contrary. So one of the bugs that was fixed was a bug that I like to take advantage of, which used to be if you had an item that let you fly, you could enter or leave a secret room by just flying through the gate. There's a glitch where you just fly right out, and I used to take advantage of that all the time, but that was unfortunately fixed in the most recent update. Which sucks for the challenge rooms, and it really sucks for the other challenge rooms, because those are quite a bit harder. The umbilical cord, can't get it. Don't know what it does. It does something cool, I would assume. Do bosses appear randomly? Certain bosses have a higher chance of appearing in certain areas, but yeah, for the most part, it's random. The other type of challenge rooms are just boss challenge rooms. Yeah, but you have to be a half health to enter them, I think. Which makes them a little trickier. I'm a gigantic brain. Now I will leave Earth for no reason. make you leave Earth, you fucking brain. Oh yeah, I can't bomb those. Never mind, I guess I'll use a key. Two of spades, double keys. Start checking for some secret rooms since I haven't been. I won't go too far out of my way looking for them, but you know, if there's one nearby, that'd be cool. Which boss is the worm? I thought it was the blighted ovum, but apparently there's a worse version of that called the bloated ovum, which I'm not looking forward to seeing anytime soon. Yeah, I mean, it's really a matter of opinion who the worst boss is. I mean, the worst boss is Satan. The worst boss I've ever fought is the boss of... Oh. Well, look at that. Oh. It's an alternate version of Peep. Excellent. Alright, I think I'm gonna try dropping some science on this guy. And by science, I mean bombs. Oh! Well, that was fun. He is Peep with Brimstone. Okay, I definitely agree. That guy is worse than the Blighted Ovum. I concede the point. Alright, well, let's give it another go. Why not? Now I no longer have all that awesome stuff. It's always a problem with this game. Alright, note to self, the bloat is bad news. Yes, that was the first time I've ever gotten that guy. I hate it when the spiders are stuck in corners like this, because you have to coax them out and you can't do that without getting hit. But what I like doing is trying to shoot them between the little cracks here. If you move up while you fire... Oh, never mind. He came out. Spider came out to play. This is why I can only play one game of any given roguelike at a time. I can usually play a couple games before I have to quit. I'm pretty hard to frustrate. I have a very high threshold for frustration. This is the mushroom that has the potential to do something bad, I think. But since I'm right at the beginning of the game, I'll go ahead and try it, since if it sucks, I can just restart. Damage up. Okay. Yeah, that was pretty good. I think it has a chance of, like, of slowing you down or reducing your damage or something like that. At least that's what I read. That might not be accurate. A lot of information about this game is hearsay. Oh, one of the other patterns for the secret rooms is that they never spawn next to an item room. So I was pretty sure this was the secret room because it's adjacent to, well, it's the only place on the map that's adjacent to two other rooms but not adjacent to the item room. So I felt pretty confident that that was the secret room. And again, these might no longer apply since the Wrath of the Lamb update, but I'm pretty sure that they do still apply. Is there no way of saving your game anywhere? Nope. That's a roguelike. When you're dead, you're dead. Oh, wow. I actually didn't get Widow on the cellar. Pretty shocked. I know this is why you come to my streams. Hot Duke on Duke action. Duke versus Duke. This thing spawns soul hearts and gives you a damage boost, I think. Or it might be a shot speed boost. I think it's shot speed. Oh, welcome, Lord Tamar. Oh, welcome, McGack. I did not see either of you arrive. Thank you for coming. It's been an excellent stream so far. You guys came at an opportune time. I really hate what the that item I just got did to poor Cain's eyes. That's really disturbing. There aren't many items in this game that I find disturbing, mostly because I'm so desensitized, but this item and the toothpick item I find really unsettling. And they both involve the eyes. Of course, I've always been squeamish about things going into my eyes. Like, I hate opening my eyes underwater when I'm swimming. And I'm also squeamish about eyes popping out of my skull. Is that a phobia? An irrational fear of your eyes popping out of your skull? I'm pretty sure it must be. Everything's a phobia. Oh, welcome, Lamex, to the chat room. Lamex says I'm talking too much. Well, I apologize, but that's kind of the point of the stream, is to talk and play. So I can answer people's questions or describe what the items in the game do. I mean, if you just want to watch, you know, straight gameplay, there are plenty of videos on YouTube that I'm sure just have that. Oh, man. I hate these things because their jumping pattern is so unpredictable. Like, you think you're safe because they're halfway across the screen from you when suddenly they jump, you know, the length of two basketball courts right into your face. Phobophobia, fear of fear itself. Well, you know, that's the only thing we have to fear. Ooh! Steven. Oh, never mind. That's Steven, not little Steve. That gives me a damage boost, not a familiar. The PhD gives you better pills, and I'm pretty sure Cain has that ability already with the lucky foot. At least I assume so. The hopper spiders are like flame hoppers without the requirements for flames. Yeah, but I'm pretty sure the spiders can be set on fire too. Which would just be like double nasty. Damn, I was hoping there would be a secret there. Ah, well. Alright, where have I not checked for secrets? I'm pretty sure this is a good candidate. If not that, then probably that. I had a hunch. Do I want to go into the pain room? Usually, in my experience, the pain room isn't worth it. It does half a heart of damage to you every time you enter. Okay, in this case, it was worth it. It was very worth it. Wow. But it seems like half the time I go into the pain room, the chests just have spiders or flies in them. Which is really just adding insult to injury. It's like you have to hurt yourself to enter this room. And what do you get? Something else that can hurt you. Actually, I guess it's adding injury to injury. And the spoon. Speed up. It'd be nice if I had a key. I have enough coins that I might be able to buy something nice from an item shop, but I don't. Oh, I guess I'm obligated to talk about E3, since that happened recently. I didn't watch the Microsoft press conference, or the Ubisoft one, but I watched Sony's and Nintendo's. Yeah. That was sure a thing. I don't know, like, I like the concept of the Wii U. I like the augmented reality stuff that's possible with it, but I don't think that was a very impressive press conference at all. Sony's has some cool stuff, but I'm probably never going to get a PlayStation 3, whereas there's actually a chance that I might get a Wii U. I don't know. Probably not, but definitely looks cool. I was really hoping they would announce like a date or a price for the Wii U, since, you know, those are the only few things that anyone really cares about it. But I guess that information will have to wait for, what's the next one, GDC? Pretty sure GDC is coming up relatively soon. The game that they showed at the end of the PlayStation conference, The Last of Us or whatever, that actually looked kind of cool. But again, I'll probably never have a PS3. So it's moot. And Nintendo's, I don't know. It's like they start off, I thought Nintendo's conference started off really promising. You know, with Arkham City coming to the console and, you know, their claim that they were focusing more on quote-unquote core gamers, but it pretty much went downhill after that. That Nintendo Land stuff just did not look interesting. I mean, it looked kind of interesting in the same way that Wii Sports was kind of fun, but they spent way too much time talking about Nintendo Land. So yeah, I don't know. Still skeptical, but I mean, there was a lot of hate about both of those conferences when you were following the Twitter feeds, well, the Twitter feeds that I follow, and I don't know if that kind of vitriol was really warranted. I mean, it's like the comic says, quit getting mad at video games. Man, I need some keys. Watchdog looks interesting. I didn't see that, but I heard good things about it. This year's E3 was mostly embarrassing, yeah. Oh, Saya-chan, welcome. I don't think I said hello to you. Oh, Auroral Visage and Che Anners, welcome. Oh, Grey Words, wow, a lot of people that I didn't see because Twitch is being dumb. Thank you for coming to the stream. Oh, no Zelda game in the Wii U's conference. And another thing that was really disappointing was no information about Last Guardian on PS3. I mean, I'm probably not going to buy a PS3, but another game from Team Ico could be one of the things that would push me over the edge. Oh boy. Well, I only have 2 bombs, so I better make them count. Damn. I was hoping for a key. I might have to pass this item room up. That would be a damn shame. Oh yeah, that Twilight book stuff. Or not Twilight, the Wonder Book for the PS3. That looked pretty dumb. Oh, Rob, welcome. And Mindcry. Twitch looks different. What's changed? They changed the layout a lot, and I don't know. They changed something that makes the chat no longer work right. They added the awesome new non-functional chat feature. That's so popular these days. Mindcry says Last Guardian is dead, and I really hope that's not the case. Because Ico and Shadow of the Colossus were like two of my favorite games of the last 10 years. And it would be a damn shame if that project never came to fruition. I've seen some people theorize that it's being held back to the PS4 release. Or pushed back, rather. But I don't know. That's just wild speculation. And still no keys. Damn. Oh, Lyrex. Wow. Haven't seen you. Lyrex says Last Guardian is dead. And that's really depressing. Duke, I've been watching your Pugsy LP. Is there any reason why you always use that big fox as a title picture? I think it's a raccoon. And the reason I use that raccoon as my picture is because when I was doing the Pugsy LP, it was back in the days when YouTube would use your, you couldn't actually set it a profile picture on YouTube. It would just pick a still from the middle of one of your videos, and it picked that still out of that Pugsy video. And I thought, wow, that's a pretty damn good profile pick to just randomly be picked from a video. So I set it as my avatar, and I've kind of held up the tradition. Now that Ueda is gone, who's heading the team on it? Well, it was my understanding that Ueda is no longer a Sony employee, but they were still hiring him on a contractual basis. I'm not sure if that's the case or not. That's what I've heard. But I really don't know. I mean, yeah, if he's off the project entirely, then yeah, I would say he's pretty much dead. Lost Vikings is my favorite LP of yours. Thank you. It's one of my favorite LPs of mine, too. It's definitely one of the most fun. He's no longer a Sony employee, but he's consulting. Yeah, that's what I heard. I'm not sure, you know, how much of a role he's playing as a consultant. Damage plus health. Nice. Wow, my damage is maxed out. Excellent. But yeah, that's pretty much my opinion of E3. It was pretty blah. I want to see more 3DS and Vita stuff, says Sayachan. Yeah, that's another thing about the Sony's conference. There was really nothing about the Vita at all. Nothing exciting has ever come out of E3, Rob says. Yeah, that's probably true. I never really played that close attention. It's always out of GDC. Oh, Reptile Blades, welcome. The one cool thing about E3 was that I was able to watch the Sony and Nintendo press conferences. Well, not Sony, but Nintendo's press conference. I actually watched / listened to on my phone while I was at work, because they were streaming it on Twitch and I could just watch it on my Twitch app, which was pretty neat. So yeah, I mean, technologically is pretty cool, even if the actual content of the presentation left a lot to be desired. Also, was it just me, or was, like, nobody actually prepared for E3 at all? Like, nobody had rehearsed their lines or anything. Like, people were constantly flubbing their lines and having to look at the teleprompter and, you know, stepping on their own lines. It just seemed really unprofessional. And that's Super Sloth for you. Oh, now they're talking about Smash Brothers in the chat room. A topic that I have no opinion on. I wish Sony could just come out and say that their Sony All-Stars game was inspired by Super Smash Brothers. I mean, everybody knows it. And them not saying it just makes them look dumb. If you look at the YouTube video for Sony All-Stars on the official PlayStation YouTube channel, the tags are Super Smash Brothers, SSB, like Smash Brothers Brawl, on the official YouTube video. So, I mean, they know exactly what they're doing. Everybody knows what they're doing. Why can't they just say it? I mean, it's not like it's something to be ashamed of, taking inspiration from another game for your game. I mean, remember back in the day when every first-person shooter was a Doom clone? That's what people called it. Remember how silly that was? And now, first-person shooters, you know, the most respected, well, one of the most respected genres of game out there. It's like, look, at some point, you just have to build off of the ideas that came previously. I mean, look at Tower Defense. I mean, Tower Defense is a genre that spawned out of one game, Tower Defense, which was based on, like, a Warcraft mod or something. And now there are a billion Tower Defense games, and, you know, nobody says, oh, you're totally ripping off desktop Tower Defense for this game. I just think it's silly. Shitty layout for these guys. I mean, Smash Brothers itself was heavily influenced by Power Stone. Nobody bitched about Smash Brothers being a Power Stone ripoff. Oh yeah, some people did. But no one paid any attention to them. Oh, the fork. Excellent. This is the item I was thinking of that makes hearts spawn randomly when you clear a room. Fuck, I hate this layout, man. I have to get right up next to these guys to shoot them. I probably should have gotten hit there. Come on. Pop up, stupid. Damn it. Alright, wow, I have a lot of money, once again. I won't spend too much time in here, but I would like to at least get a couple keys. Smash Brothers came out before Power Stone, are you sure? Because Power Stone was a Dreamcast game. I mean, I guess Smash Brothers was like a late era N64 game. Well, either way, I'm sure they came out close enough together that neither of them, like, directly was influenced by the other. Aw, no poopat for me. a lot of parts spawning. I wonder if that has anything to do with my fork. Alright, well, I guess that's good enough. I might go back there later if I need supplies. I'm not sure. Did I get the item room on this floor? I don't remember because I don't have the map. I'm crippled without the map. Duke, why is an infant throwing stuff at you? That's the show game guy. You can win fabulous prizes by playing his game. Well, let's see. I should probably go ahead and pick up that Steam sale. Ooh, luck up. Nice. Nah, I don't need to get that bomb. Okay. Well, that was a worthwhile endeavor. Lyric says, that only proves that neither game ripped each other off. Yeah, I mean, that's true. Okay. But still. I mean, Smash Brothers is a, I mean, it's a formula that I'm sure a lot of games could use to their advantage. I mean, a lot of games have ripped off the Street Fighter formula. But they're still, you know, decent fighting games. I don't know. I just think the internet gets too up in arms about that kind of stuff. Of course, the internet gets too up in arms about everything. I should probably just stop paying attention to the internet. It causes me nothing but heartburn. Damn it. Alright, well, that went pretty well. And I got little Chad. I have two heart spawning items. CPC Gamer says, I call them mascot fighters and look at the games for what they are. Yes, exactly. It is a genre of game, the mascot fighter. I mean, I don't play Super Smash Brothers. I think it's dumb, but I don't see the big deal about Sony copying the formula. That said, it would be less of a big deal if they could just come out and say, you know, we took inspiration from Super Smash Brothers and we made a game using Sony characters. I wish we lived in a world where they could just say that. Aww. I knew my luck would run out eventually. There are a lot of new enemies that are based on greed. Most of them you don't encounter until way later in the game. Damn it. But there's like a greed head that bounces around and shoots the three bullet pattern. Jesus Christ. Got it. I took way too much damage from that guy. I don't know why, I just can't deal with greed's pattern. Duke, you want honesty in marketing, you silly. Yeah, I know. I hate these things. Oh my god. The reason why I hate these things is that they don't play fair. And I'll tell you why. There's an item you can get that gives you a shot, just like their little maggot things. It's a little maggot that that occasionally jumps out and, you know, does pretty decent damage to whatever hits. But the version that you can pick up can't go through rocks. But the version these guys shoot can go through rocks. It's not fair, I tells you. Man, I have taken way too much damage. Jesus Christ. I hope this guy starts spawning some hearts soon. That's what happens when I get up on my soapbox. I stop paying attention and I start making mistakes. It'd be kind of a bummer if I can't even make it to the cathedral on this playthrough. Oh, Smarty Man, welcome. Welcome to the chat room. Alright, see you later, CPC Gamer. Let's see, I'll take one of those, and one of those, and one of those, just in case I get an item later. Man, second playthrough in a row, no activated items. That's kind of an anomaly. I mean, I usually get something. If nothing else, at least like Lemon Mishap or something. 50 viewers, seriously? See, I can only see 22 in my chat window thing. Because Twitch is being dumb. So anyone I haven't said hello to, welcome. If you like the stream, please follow me on Twitch if you want to. And I also have a Twitter and Facebook page where you can also follow me. I would appreciate it. More numbers means more people in the chat room, which means more fun. Well, up to a point. Once you get too many people in a chat room, then the fun starts decreasing. These are the enemies that play off of greed that I was talking about. And I'm actually going to shut up for a minute here. Oh, and YouTube too. I've gotten a ton of YouTube subscribers in the last month or so. I can't believe it. I don't know where the hell they're coming from. But if any of you have subscribed to me on YouTube recently, thank you. Twitch only shows 26 in the chat room. Oh, well, maybe the other ones don't actually have accounts and they're not logged in. They're just watching. But if you're not in the chat room, then, you know, thanks for watching still. Every little bit helps. I lost a ton of YouTube subscribers because YouTube did a purge recently of inactive users, and I dropped down to a little under 2,000. I had like 2,200, but my numbers have been pretty steadily increasing. I'll go ahead and use that. That sounds pretty good. Duke, you were like the first LPR I saw, so you got a history with me. You mean you got a history with me. But still, thank you. I'm not sure what this is. I don't know if I've gotten this or not. Scapular, you have been blessed. Alright, see you later, Darian Mask. Oh, where's Draconis? See you guys later. Thanks for coming. I'm not entirely sure what being blessed does. Now, the Pope hat, it also says that you're blessed. So I'm not sure if this has the same effect as the Pope hat or if it's a different effect. And the Pope hat also increases your luck a little bit. So maybe blessed is just another word for luck. I'm not entirely sure. Scapular. It seems when you get down to half a heart, it gives you a soul heart. Oh, excellent. It means you won't sneeze anymore because you've been blessed. Oh, God. Not these guys. Oh, Jesus. Oh, crap. Oh, shit. Oh, God. Okay, sorry for the silence there. I am pretty screwed. Now That room really sucked. I could start bombing around and see if I can find the other secret room. Or I could go explore a little bit more and see if I get a, oh! Wow, I did not even see that there. Well, that's kind of helpful, I guess. Now, in my experience, I have no idea if this is true or not, but in my experience, the other secret room seems to be it always seems to be at a dead end. Like it's at like it would be there or like just connected to one room, no other rooms. Yeah, there's two secret rooms. There's a standard one and then there's one that can either have a bunch of hearts, or it can have like a fortune telling machine or something. Yes, the top secret room, as Smarty Man says. Is there something that gives you full health? Yeah, there's a full health pill. And also the Sun tarot card gives you full health. But those are both pretty uncommon. Oh Jesus. At least it's not the maggot ones. Alright, let's try here. Again, I have no idea if that's actually a pattern or not. It's just something I seem to have noticed. Oh lord. A lot of this game is looking for patterns and testing to see if it's a pattern or not. Or just random luck. Now I'm at the top of the map, so there's probably not going to be anything further north of here. I don't know, the map could zoom out. It does that sometimes. That's the Sun. That's the one that gives you full health. Ah, there it is. And it's just the pin. Oh well. But I got the Sun, which is awesome. I want to hold on to it until the boss room, because what the Sun does is it reveals the map. I hope I have the right card. It reveals the map, it does a lot of damage to every enemy on the screen, and it also heals you all the way. That's a thumbtack. Well, they call it the pin. P-I-N. Not P-E-N. It's like a push pin. Save Sun for emergencies. Yeah. I don't know. Part of me wants to just go into the room and just blast him with the Sun right off the bat. Sun is literally the best card in the game. Yes, that is true. Does a pin not do anything good? It makes some of your tiers spectral, so that they can pass through rocks. And I'd rather have the fork. Oh, it's bloat. Okay. I'm definitely using my card now. Somebody in the chat room said it was going to be bloat, and it was. Why do people in my chat room always jinx me? Okay. Don't stand under him. Wow, he does not telegraph that at all, does he? Jesus Christ. Oh my god. Okay, don't stand under him or to the side of him. Alright. Now, Lyrax said he hasn't seen him shoot up. So I'm going to stand above him and test that theory. Hopefully he's like a dog and he can't look up. Dogs can't look up. Did you know that? Not a lot of people know that, but it's true. His only weakness being above him. Oh, that was Rain, not Lyrax. Sorry. Alright, well, I guess that could have gone a lot worse. Don't listen to Big Al. Yeah, it looks like Rain was right. He did not fire up while I was standing above him. But, you know, that might have just been luck. Get the knuckles and mom's eye to shoot teeth out of the back of your head. Yeah, that's kind of cool. I'd rather have a good item, though. Oh, Daz a W. I don't think I said hello, but welcome. The new enemies don't have official names yet, but I call these guys walking boils, or walking egg sacks in the case of the white one. Aw, man, just bad gas. If you back in and out of a blue spike room, I think you can get rid of them that way. Oh yeah, they're gone. Usually there's an enemy in the same room, so you're stuck until you can kill the enemy. But yeah, if it's just the spike things, you can just walk in and out and get rid of them. I forgot about that. Well, the ladder is kind of useful. I'd rather have a holy grail or something that can make you fly. Look like walking tomatoes. Yeah, the red ones kind of do. Let's see, should I take my chances with the pain room? Well, I spawned a heart up here. Actually, I'm going to wait and see. I'll try the pain room if I lose my soul heart. Because if I lose regular hearts, I can just replenish those, but I'll hang on to my soul heart for a little while. Damn. Oh, fuck. I didn't even see that fly. I thought I got hit by one of the blood globules. I'll come back to you later, if necessary. Aw, man. Oh well. At least there are no rocks in this one. That makes these rooms a little easier to deal with. The soul hearts are connected to the masks. You can't attack the masks. Or not the soul hearts. The hearts are connected to the masks. Once you kill the heart, the mask goes with it. There's also a boss based on the heart of the mask. Okay. This is an instance where the ladder actually comes in handy. Because you can just chill on the hole and the mask can't get to you, in theory. Of course, these hearts can also fire blood at you, so you don't want to get too close to those either. Wait, I'm at half hearts. Shouldn't this thing be open? I thought this thing opened when you were at half health. A ladder that acts as a bridge. Yeah, it's basically a Legend of Zelda ladder. The item room's got to be close. No, there is a challenge room that opens when you're at full health, but you see how on the map the icon has a bloody sword instead of a regular sword? Those are different than the normal challenge rooms. And I heard that they open when you're at half health, but it doesn't seem to be the case. Alright, I have quite a few bombs, so I can probably start looking for secret rooms in a minute. Oh dear. I'm not going to take my chances in this room. I'm just going to chill down here. Well, that was the plan anyway. I should really start listening to my own advice. Rusty key. Not sure what that does. Something about dropping keys or dropping coins or something. Aw, man. This thing's okay. But this late in the game, there are definitely more useful items I could have. Oh, the other challenge room, apparently you have to be at one heart or less to open. That's what Reptile Blade says. Alright, I'm going to gamble a little bit and see if I can get some hearts. And then I will go start looking for secrets before I go to the boss. Damn, I was hoping I would get another poopat. And I'm out. I've gotten a room with just the headless horseman's head by itself and a room with blue spikes. It always commits suicide. Yeah, that's happened to me. Actually, it's happened to me with multiple headless horsemen. You can spawn rooms with up to three of them in it. Yeah, I seem to be lucky, except when it comes to those secret rooms. Alright. I think I'm done. I'm not going to bother with the pain room. I just want to grab this heart and go on and fight Mom. Well, I guess I could gamble. Okay. I'll try to get my hearts up. Oh, that worked out well. Hello, weird infant. We meet again. If you don't like weird infants, then this is not the game for you. Because there are plenty of weird infants in this game. Alright, I guess I'm ready. Wow, look at how big my teeth are. I don't know if the teeth actually deal extra damage, or if they just deal splash damage. I think it's just splash damage. Like when the tooth explodes, it does damage to some nearby enemies. Oh, damn you! You're supposed to die. Stupid meat man. Damn it! Bumped into the eye. This isn't nearly as cool as when I had my laser. Whew. chocolate milk. Damn it. Why couldn't it be something useful? Oh well. Man, this fork and this guy really aren't spawning as many hearts as they should be. Cain has two eyes popped out. Yeah, I picked up the little doll thing with the popped out eyes. Chocolate milk isn't that good anymore. Yeah, I never liked chocolate milk. Oh shit. The doppelgangers are very easy to deal with, especially in a room like this, since you can just waft them into the spikes. Otherwise, you can just guide them into a bomb. Oh shit, there was a heart there. Fuck, how'd I miss that? Oh god. Away from me. Oh, thank you. The Empress. I should really know what all these tarot cards do by now. Kind of wish they made Utero look a bit different. Yeah, Utero is the only one where they didn't really change the appearance of the room at all. Oh, right. The Empress. Whew. That probably should have hit me. Alright, let's start poking around here and see if I can find any secrets. Empress's mom's foot. Yeah, that's what I always think too. I always get the Empress and the High Priestess mixed up. Oops, I already checked that way. Oh well. Hi, Larry. Hi, other two Larrys. Wow, at the boss already. That is pretty fortuitous. I think I'm not gonna dick around on any other part of this floor and just head straight to the boss. I mean, it's always a trade-off. I mean, I could go around the floor trying to collect some more hearts, or I could go around the floor and I could get my ass handed to me. The bicycle cars are really easy to remember, yeah. That's the nice thing about them. There's a two of hearts. Oh, and the two of diamonds doubles your coins. I don't think I mentioned that one earlier. Please be Skolex or some other easy boss. Whoa. It's Loki, but he's split in two. That's weird. Looks like it's pretty much just the same as having two Lokis. I don't think they've ever spawned Bloodflies before, though. At least not in my recollection. Ooh, an Eternal Heart. Nice. That turns into a full heart once you go down four. I was really hoping this would be the Angel Room, and not the Double Room. Loki, the double Loki fight. Loki times two. Yeah, I'm not giving up a heart for either of those things. Let's check these blocks. Just out of curiosity. Okay. I didn't think I could be that lucky, but I thought I'd give it a try. These things are actually pretty easy to deal with if you're patient. Oh shit. I did exactly the thing you're not supposed to do with the doppelganger. hate those eyeballs. The other eyeballs are bad enough. I am another gigantic brain. It's kind of weird that a brain turns into guts. I don't remember reading about that in anatomy class. Of course, I guess this thing isn't really a brain. It's more just like a big mass of organs. It's too colorful to be a brain. Oh, wow, the fork actually did something. That was a fork effect when I cleared that room and it made the yum heart sound. The fork occasionally does that. But apparently, it's a lot more occasionally than I thought it was. It's supposed to be a big pile of guts. Yeah, I know, but it looks like a brain. Well, kinda. If you don't pay attention to the color. Shit. I unlocked the wafer, which is like a damage reduction item, but I've only gotten it once. Just kind of a bummer. Man, my damage right now is just ridiculous. Whew! Well, let's see. See, the big giant guts thing is prone to spawning in rooms with the brains, which makes me think it's another brain. This looks like a pretty good candidate for a secret. Nope. Oh well. Huge guts. Well, let's try here. See you later, reptile blades. Glad you can make it. Wish I had more bombs. Welcome to the chat room, Dreekas. Blood in the Red Room sounds like a good band name. Sounds like one of those screamo bands. Damn, that was my last bomb, too. Huh. It's weird. It has hearts, but no masks. Well, I'm not going to complain. It's another good name for a screamo band. Hearts, but no masks. Nope. Wow, double gluttony. Oh well, better than super gluttony. The twist, everyone in the band wears a mask. Wow, that's like totally ironic. It's like rain on your wedding day. Let's go back for the heart. Hey, excellent. Too bad there's nothing to open on this floor. Well, there's these. And more useless coins. Man, it is seriously gonna make me explore this whole goddamn floor until before I find the boss. Mystery pills. Whoa. That was weird. It was question marks and then it told me what it does. Huh. That must be an effect of an item that I picked up. Maybe that's what the PhD does. I always thought the PhD was just, better luck on pill drops. Does it actually tell you what they do? Weird. Oh, Super Danks. Welcome. What's the yellow key for? The gold key can open any lock on this floor. It goes away once I'm off this floor, but, if there was an item room, you could open that. Any locked chests, any shops, you can open all of them. Apparently that is what the PhD does. Huh. Oh shit. Let's see, I can take this guy out the easy way or the fun way. I think I'm gonna go for the easy way. Ah, shit. Well, this is the final boss, so I think I'm gonna go back for another heart. Well, quote-unquote final. The final boss before I get to the cathedral. Man, that is a long-ass way to go. Fuck that. I'll go back for later if I need to. Oh, is Little Chad a Super Meat Boy character? I played Super Meat Boy, but I never made it that far in it. Alright, first order of business, take out these eyes. This boss always spawns with laser eyes on the other side of it. I really wish I had some better stuff. I mean, I'm doing pretty decent damage, but that's pretty much it. Hi, Monstro. Did Mom let you come over and play? That was awfully nice of her. Even with all my damage, I'm still not doing squat to this thing. It Lives is a pretty tough boss. Oh lord. I have my laser right now. Damn it. Saw that one coming. Couldn't get out of the way in time. I think this boss is tougher with the expansion too. I don't know. It seems to have more health than before. Of course, I only fought it a couple times before I got the expansion. Alright, when this thing starts vomiting, the best thing to do is to stay to the left or the right. Because most of the shots are going to go on the bottom half of the screen.
Whew.
All right. Well, I really hate to do this, but I think I'm going to get back for the heart. I guess I could look for secrets with the two bombs that I have. Actually, it would be really convenient if this was a secret. But I probably already tried that from the other side. Alright, well, now that I have defeated It Lives, it's on to the cathedral. I've only done the cathedral once, and the one time I went through it, I was super broken. I had Technology 2 and the Mulligan, so I was spawning just a million blue flies everywhere I went. It was pretty beautiful. But this time, I do not have as good of an item spread. Yes, Anime Flame, that is the final boss, technically. But there are two additional areas I can go to now. The pit takes you to Sheol, and if you step into the spotlight, it takes you to the cathedral. The true final area of the game. Now, the one time I played through the cathedral, it was easier than Sheol, in my opinion. Because in Sheol, pretty much the only enemies that spawn are bosses. Whereas in the cathedral, it actually gives you a break and spawns some easier stuff like these guys. Although I still got hit by them. Damn it. Oh, that was nice of you. Okay. I didn't notice that these things had flies circling around them. I wonder if that's a new version of that enemy. Or if I just never noticed the flies before. Well, I guess it is a new version of the enemy, because the circling flies is something that they added in Wrath of the Lamb. Damn it. And this is two headless horseman heads. I've seen as many as three spawn in the same room before. It's a bitch to deal with. Okay. Definitely will get Wrath of the Lamb. So much new content. Yeah, I highly recommend it. I really wish I had a bomb. Oh lord. Speaking of three horseman heads. I hate it when I start moving opposite directions like that. At least when they're both moving the same direction. Whew, that was close. You can kind of hang out on one side of the screen. Alright, I am going to take these bombs and I am going to go back and get that chest. Okay, that was quite worth it. Whew. Sorry if I'm not talking for this part. I'm gonna have to focus. That white thing's like a cross between the gish and the meat. Shoots in eight directions. Very nasty. And empty room. I wish I was able to get that compass when I had the chance. But I did not have the funds. Damn. You know, I wonder if Monster 2 also can't shoot up. It's interesting. I don't think I've ever seen him shoot his blood beam up. Of course, Monstro's constantly jumping around everywhere, which makes it more difficult to get above him. But I guess Bloat is as well. Shit! Try to get out of the way. Oh god. God damn. Duke, I'm wondering, when you play alone, do you gamble all your coins away? Because that's Cain's strongest point. I do if I don't have anything else to spend my money on. Monster 2 is sideways only. Yeah, good to know. I could have sworn he shot down as well. Alright, well, that'll about do it for this attempt at the Binding of Isaac, Wrath of the Lamb. At least I actually made it to the cathedral this time. Yeah, compared to my last stream, my previous streams, it's going to be pretty difficult from here on out. I'm probably going to die a lot. But, yeah, I think I'm going to do Bastion on Thursday, take a little break from Binding of Isaac. So I will continue my New Game Plus in Bastion. But yeah, thanks everyone who came out. Hope you enjoyed. Hope my failure was at least somewhat entertaining. And I'll see you all again, hopefully, on Thursday. Later.